The SLHTA launched a one-week skills training exercise earlier this week in collaboration with the Caribbean Development Bank to assist small hotels in marketing themselves more in a bid to increase their occupancy. Noorani Azeez says that over the past few years, he has noticed that small hotels have been seriously impacted by the worsening economic situation. According to the vice president of the Saint Lucia Hotel and Tourism Association, the issue is of major concern to the SLHTA, he says, particularly over the fact that almost 20 small properties, which are SLHTA members, have been crying out for quite some time now for support to increase their occupancy levels and better manage their product.
We're concerned that what's happening right now is going to trouble investors greatly. I am of the personal conviction that governments should not be held responsible for creating sustainable long-term employment. That's really the responsibility of the private sector. And I think governments need to focus on how they create that facilitating environment for the private sectors to grow. Part of the discussion we're having here this morning is to look at particularly that. You know, for some time now we have been working with the St. Lucia Manufacturers Association, and we've opened up that type of dialogue on how the various perspectives on the private sector on what can be done differently in order to stimulate growth, in order to pull us out of this tailspin, is considered and applied in a holistic manner.
Mr. Azeez says as a grouping, the small hotels hold lots of potential for the destination. He believes, however, that a lot of that potential has been untapped.
For many of these properties, it's really a one-man operation, and it's very difficult for them to be chief cook and bottle washer at this time. We're very sensitive to those needs, and we understand that it will be a hand-holding experience. You know, we really have to walk them the full distance in order to ensure their stability and ensure that the many dollars that they've invested in their property starts to generate some degree of return on investment. We really applaud the fact that I think over 90% of these properties are locally owned. They're properties whose investors have mortgaged their personal assets in order to invest and to, you know, to try to make something of it. And we respect and we applaud that. I mean, for many years now, they have been trying to put one foot in front of the other.
The vice president of the St. Lucia Hotel and Tourism Association says that at this stage, the island has no room for blind optimism.
That has had an impact. We're on record as saying, look, we fully support the fact that the private sector has got to make its contribution towards the taxes at a national level. These taxes go into communities and work towards the well-being of every citizen, every resident, every visitor of the country. So it's important that we honor that commitment. The manner in which we roll it out has always been an issue of concern for the Hotel and Tourism Association, and we're on record as stating that. We believe that there are sufficient best practices that can be put on the table. And I think the time now, after 1 year, it's important that we all come together, sit at the table, look at what some of the shortcomings are and how we can best tweak them in order to ensure that the coming year for us, you know, is a more viable one, both for the private sector and the public sector.
As a country, Mr. Azeez says it is now important that all stakeholders come up with fresh and innovative ideas to salvage the vital sector. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.